Hey there, I'm David, and today we're going to talk about how you can expand your design workflows by using Arkio and integrating Rhino and Enscape to enhance your visualization. So jump right in. We've been exploring this new site recently, and we found this small pond, and there was these ideas to make something right there and then. I wanted to keep working on the project off-site, and in order to do that, I'll need to capture the conditions I was experiencing with mixed reality. And the best way I like to do that is with a quick photosphere. It's literally like taking a quick capture of the site home with me. So this workflow is going to have us exporting the model that we created in Arkio into Rhino, apply the photosphere that we captured, and then render the final view in Enscape. Let's go through this step by step, starting with the photosphere. First thing you want to do is get your key location that you're going to render your view from. And then you want to grab your phone and use an app like Polycam to start constructing the actual photosphere. Polycam has a really simple UI that will help you walk through the photosphere process. And then afterwards, you can export that image as a skybox that you'll use for your renderings later. The second thing that we'll do is export the model from Arkio so we can access it on our desktop for later. I'll enter in a cloud group ID onto my device. This way I can share the model directly from the device over to the desktop without any cords or cables, and then when I go to export from Arkio, I can select what type of file format I want to use, and I'll send it over to Rhino by hitting the Rhino button. Jumping over to Rhino, we'll use that same cloud group to download the files from the cloud. Once it's downloaded, we'll select the file and import it into Rhino. And then once we have it here, I just like to get rid of the table so we have the model that I want to focus on here. Now we want to add the photosphere to it. And how we can do that is just literally creating a gigantic sphere that will be at the center point of our model. And just make sure you scale and position it as you see fit. Now, to complete the setup, all we need to do is create a single material, grab our image that we created as a photosphere from Polycam, and assign it as the main texture to that material. Once we apply the material to our sphere, you'll notice the photosphere wrap around the sphere itself. Since it's on there, you might need to rotate and scale the texture in order to get it into the right position and orientation. Before I go any further, I'll do a little bit of cleanup so I can get my geometry and materials organized just the way I like it. I'll actually set my views as well, and I added in a little bit of recessed lighting around the edges. While Arkio's material library really helped us capture our overall design vision, we're going to rely on Enscape's materials to really push that quality to the next level. I'm going to focus on the floors, the walls, the ceiling to create a couple of different iterations for me to test. This is looking pretty good, so what I'm going to do now is just open up Enscape, and I think we're ready to go. Okay, so we have everything set up. Let's just jump right in Enscape to see how we're looking, and this is looking great. This is the prime view that I wanted to have when I was capturing my photosphere. It really helps to start to show how versatile Arkio is when you can import something that you've been modeling in the headset and bring it into a program like Enscape to really create a high-end visualization. And I remember on site we found some swings nearby, and I thought it'd be kind of fun if the purpose of this space was to have one single swing, and I found that asset in Enscape, so why not bring it in and add it? On a little bonus material here is, since we've gone through the process of setting up the materials, the texture, and the scene within Rhino, we can actually export that back into Arkio and share that with anyone as a collaborative design review, which is really helpful when you want to be able to capture something in mixed reality when people don't have the same site as you. And that wraps up our Arkio to Enscape use case. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any questions about this process or have any comments about how these type of workflows go, you can reach out directly to us at community.arkio.is. Looking forward to seeing what you make, and see you soon.